Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea.
Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us.
March on to victory.
Hello, my name is Jacoby Taylor, the salutatorian for the CVCA class of 2020. I would like to welcome you to the graduation ceremony of the CVCA Class of 2020. As we begin our new journey in our lives, we must remember we entered the world during 9/11, we graduated during a pandemic, we can't endure anything.
Jen Steinbeck once said, "I'm impelled not to speak like a graceful and apologetic mouse, but to roar like a lion out of pride." My name is Moya Seroluwa-Udubimi, valedictorian for the class of 2020, and I'm here because today marks the end of a remarkable journey. Before I proceed, it is only right that I acknowledge the presence of all the wonderful people that were instrumental in our training and transformation through the years. Members of staff at CVS, esteemed guests, and our accomplished parents, on behalf of my humble self and my fellow graduates, I welcome you all to this memorable event. This day signifies a portal of hard work, dedication, and an endless pursuit for the best for each one of us graduating this day. Even so, may I meet every one of us with a challenge. That let today not only be a day where we immerse ourselves in celebration and commemoration, but also understand the privilege we have had to successfully complete our training here at CVS despite the uncertain times. It will then be a disappointment if we look at today as a mere graduation ceremony where we say goodbye to CVS family, high school, and the friends we have made over the past 4 years. Today is the day we should all look back to as the day we were given a voice to roar, a roar that is to define our identity. Permit me to explain what I mean by the day we were given a voice to roar, a roar that is to define our identity. Throughout our training here at CPS, we have been imparted with skills and values that makes us an exceptional set of students. I can confidently say that all of us sitting here today are unique in our own way, and we are ready to make informed decisions concerning ourselves. We have grown through unforeseen challenges, and have become like fearless, courageous lions who can determine the right time to roar and when to be discreet about our actions. Even the little things at CVS, like the courtesy sitting in front of the library and asking students to take up their hood, taught us responsibility, respect, and how to be discerning. May I mention that no one should tell you when to roar because it's your own voice, but be aware that contrary to popular belief, the lion does not usually roar when hunting wild animals. However, when trying to prey upon domestic animals in an enclosure, a lion often will roar. All this means is to be smart and cautious about whatever decisions you decide to make for yourselves. assess the situation. Stop, think, and then roar. Sometimes the lion has to be really quiet or the prey might escape, or even worse, they themselves can get killed. So remember that not every action means a reaction. Remembering this and the processes we went through are more than enough to help us through our new chapters of life. Today marks a bit of a bittersweet experience for me. A part of me is overjoyed that I've made it this far, and another part, quite frantic, about what a year will be like without the Cavaliers. You have 4 minutes to get to class music. I could go on and on. To my fellow graduates, every one of us here is a lion, ready to roar as loud as is needed at appropriate times. Today may mark the last day we all gather together, but I hope that we will all cherish this sensational memory. Ladies and gentlemen of the class of 2020, it has been an extreme privilege to serve as your class president and to deliver this speech as valedictorian. I am grateful for your unending confidence and constructive criticisms. These have helped me to become a better person and a better leader. Till our paths cross again, remember to assess, stop, think, and then roar if necessary, as loud as you can.
Hello, everybody, and congratulations to the class of 2020.
This is a huge day for all of you, and we couldn't be more excited to be celebrating with you today. It's very exciting.
It's exciting.
Now, while you might not get the experience of sweating under your cap and gown in the hot sun or getting embarrassed by your family yelling out your name when you walk across the stage, you still have all those people with you today, just like they've been with you this whole journey, rooting you on, pushing you to grow, and offering you a hand if you needed it. Mm-hmm. These folks deserve your love and gratitude for helping you get here. So give them a squeeze if they're with you right now.
Especially the dads.
And if they're not, give them a call later. That's from the moms. This is their day too.
So today is the culmination of a long journey. Think back to when you were starting your first year. You're probably just hoping that by graduation day, you would have found your people, learned some new skills, got yourself ready for your next step. Maybe college, maybe grad school, maybe your first job. You accomplished all that. And then just as you were rounding the final turn, the world threw a pandemic your way.
Yeah, so these past few months, you've had to reach even higher. You weren't just adjusting to a virtual classroom. You were helping your teachers adjust their audio so the rest of the class could hear. You weren't just taking your finals online, you were making sure your siblings had enough time on the computer too to do their work. And you weren't just hanging out with your friends in that group chat, you were supporting them through all this uncertainty and loss.
That's a lot to ask of anybody, but in spite of it all, here you are. And we want you to know that all the work you've put in to get your education is still one of the best investments you can make. We've seen it for decades. The more education you have, the better you and your families are likely to fare. It's been borne out over the past couple of months, and it will be the case for years to come. So you all have done something great. Hold your heads high and celebrate.
Go ahead and do a little dance. Well, a cool dance, just for yourself. Maybe even not so cool if you're just by yourself. Yeah. Embarrass yourself.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again, when I see you again.
Damn. No. All the planes we flew, good things we've been through. Then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place.
Can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began.
You know, we started.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I'll tell you.
When I see you again.
You both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong and what's small turn to a friendship turn to a bond and that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost. And when brotherhood come first then the line will never be crossed, established it on our own when that line had to be drawn and that line is what we reach, so remember me when I'm gone.
Can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
So let the light guide your way. Yeah. Hold every memory as you go. And every road you take will always lead you. It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Months ago, I had a nice apartment in Chicago. I had a good job. I had a son. When something happened to the Negroes in the South, I said, that's their business, not mine. Now I know I was wrong. The murder of my son has shown me that what happens to any of us, anywhere in the world, had better be the business of all of us. Those were the words of Miss Mamie Till Mobley, the mother of Emmett Till, who was murdered on August 28, 1955. Chicago Vocational Class of 2020, none of us could have predicted your senior year would end like this. COVID-19 stopped the world in its tracks. March 2020, thousands of people were hospitalized, and yes, some lost their lives. The work stopped and schools closed. Question, what do we do? Well, we heard many experts say many things, but in the end, it was simple. The directions were stay at home, be still. Be still, what was that? What do you do when you are still? You do two things. You listen and you watch. Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, George Floyd. We saw, we heard, we watched. The pandemic allowed us all the time and the space to lay witness to the ways in which violence against Black people in America permeates every sector of our lives. We are police while jogging. We are police while buying groceries. We are police while visiting friends. We are police while working. We are police while just being, just existing. And so now we come to this, a virtual graduation. And understandably, many of us are angry for it. We are sad and disappointed. But Cavaliers, I got to tell you, as your principal, I'm taking this moment right here to rejoice, because all of my seniors, all of my babies are here, 100% safe, 100% healthy, and 100% graduating. So the question now turns, what do we do now? You act. You create the change you want to see. You are hope. You are the chosen ones. Now I know you say, how can you say that, Mr. Macklin? Principal, this is our senior year. We've been cheated out of our best year ever. And that may seem true in this moment, but look at the extraordinary times in which you are coming of age. All of the challenges placed before you as you move into the next phase of your evolution as adults in this world. For 4 years, you took everything involving being a senior for granted. You assumed that the rites of passage enjoyed by every senior class before you would continue to be the status quo for you. You were regaled with the stories of what perks you could expect to enjoy as seniors. You watched the classes of 2017, 2018, and 2019 and take it all in. Mentally planning what you will do and how you will make your senior year even better, even more memorable. Senior night, luncheon, prom, and the final culminating event, your graduation. The status quo, all the pomp and circumstance of this year has been anticipated and planned from the time you were ninth graders. But nothing is as you have fantasized it would be. The prevalent question that every member of every senior class of 2020 around the globe is, why me? Why did this have to happen during my time to shine? Without warning, the world stage has overshadowed the auditorium stage you envisioned walking across. These turbulent times must serve as the ultimate wake-up call to you, for you are our future leaders of the world. You must be jolted into awareness and action. You are chosen to shift the axis of history by being catalysts for a change in the way people relate to one another, think of one another, and love one another. You must move forward with conviction and purpose. And understanding of what your place in the world be. Cavaliers, show no fear, except that these historic times have chosen you to change this world through acts of service, compassion, and faith. Chicago Vocational graduating class of 2020, you have been imbued with the gift of seeing yourselves in a world of your own making. You must move as one, be bold, and go forth and make the world great. We are Cavaliers, committed to transforming our lives by building our character in class, by connecting our values to victory, activating our creativity and competence, embracing our attitude for achievement. We represent ourselves, our family, and our school. We are our community. And I, and you, and you, and you make the difference. At CVS, we win.
Congratulations, class of 2020. My Cavaliers, I'm so proud of you. Job well done.
On behalf of the Illinois State Board of Education, Chicago Public Schools, under the direction of Chief Executive Officer, Dr. Janice Jackson, and Chief Educational Officer, LaTanya McDade, I would like to announce that Chicago Vocational Career Academy's class of 2020 has successfully met all graduation requirements and are ready to receive their high school diplomas. Principal Macklin, will you accept this class?
Thank you, Ms. Cannon. I will accept Chicago Vocational Career Academy graduating class of 2020.
Thank you.
Will the class of 2020 please rise? Please move your tassel from right to left. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the 2020 graduating class of Chicago Vocational Career Academy. Thank you for viewing our first ever virtual graduation here at the V. We love you and congratulations.